I'm State Senator Steve O'Bannon. Senator Dino Rossi and I have called for an investigatory hearing into Sound Transit to explore whether it may have engaged in a systematic effort to confuse and misrepresent the impact and cost of Sound Transit 3 authorization to legislators and the public. Why should we care about that? The language for Sound Transit's funding authorization was unconstitutionally drafted. The other party inserted language into the 2015 transportation package at the request of Sound Transit. That language was so confusing that the chair of the House Transportation Committee herself said it hadn't even occurred to her that Sound Transit would resurrect a previously repealed method to calculate car tab fees. That's how we ended up with Sound Transit using inflated car values to calculate our taxes. Sound Transit board members repeatedly told legislators that they needed the full $15 billion in taxing authority to extend light rail to Tacoma and to Everett. The House Transportation Chair told the Olympian that if Sound Transit had asked for $54 billion instead of $15 billion, it would not have gone anywhere. Nobody was going to do that. When the chair of the committee negotiating the deal describes being caught off guard, you know something was not right. We also know that Sound Transit improperly participated in the Prop 1 election. It illegally provided the email addresses of thousands of ORCA cardholders to the political campaign supporting ST3. Bottom line, Sound Transit is governed by an unelected board. Legislators and the public are expressing shock at the overall ST3 cost, and we should examine how we got here and take appropriate action.